scene, we were met as the back doors flung open, and we were met and greeted by an angry mob that were armed with bats, chains, and rocks. They were fueled by their resentment and their bitterness as they beat, spat, and hurled insults at our Savior, Jesus Christ. We must not be fooled this morning, because it's easy to think, oh, that was just them, but our faces could have easily been replaced by the faces of those who desire to crucify our Lord. Because the truth is that I am a sinner, and so are you. As they continued to beat our Lord and push him down, he made his way down the aisle and fell right here upon these steps. And upon falling, his only reward was a crown of thorns that was smashed into his forehead. And as it did, blood trickled down his forehead and into his eyes. And if that was not enough, somebody grabbed a beer bottle and smashed it against the head of our Lord and Savior. They pushed him further, and he fell upon this cross of scaffolding. And there you could hear the sound of the nails pounding into his flesh. That sound was only silenced by the cries and screams of the mob saying, "We want more, crucify him." And just above that, you could hear the wails of his mother Mary and those who loved Jesus. His pain was real. Their anger was real, and his death was real. Salvation and hope. God, who came down in the form of man, became our propitiation, an atoning death sacrifice that would somehow give life. All of history, your story, my story, hangs upon that cross. But how can there be true life and what would seem to be death? Where is victory in what most people would think is only defeat? Where is radical